This is Captain Cranky here in the laboratory, saying there's nothing like the fresh scent of styrene in the morning. Nothing like it.
Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory with an update on the NECRON SCYTHE. And I wanted to talk a little bit about, not only the paint, but also some of the tips and tricks that you learn along the way when you get on YouTube and check out the community and the folks who've been working with the NECRON armies for a few years now. And some of them, of course, are techniques that are also applicable, and one learns them when you are a different kind of model builder, i.e. Model cars, military, airplanes, you name it. An old trick, of course, is to use the silly putty that comes in the little egg, and that much. That's often all you need to work on your miniatures. We've already painted all of this with we painted them with gunmetal, and then a little chainmail, and then of course silver, and we did a little bit of highlighting. We shot the gunmetal from the bottom, and then the silver from the top, and so we've gotten this already where we want it. Of course, some of the overspray got on the rest of the model, which is fine. Using masking tape, we've masked also the silver. I don't know if it's a rib or what, but again, we don't know much about the NECRONs. We just love their models, and we're getting excited about painting them. Now we're getting ready to shoot some of our base color paint, and we are going to put down a base coat of Imperial Blue, which is a very kind of a purplish, darkish blue. And so we're going to do that next. We've got all the other parts pretty much painted and ready for a little bit of a wash and then some highlighting. We're working on this slowly. We are going to actually use a little bit of green and these three blues to create our graphics and the accents. We're talking about ultramarine blue, magic blue, and of course our favorite, electric blue. The other thing I was going to say is, using these paints, it's great that they put both the Spanish name, the Spanish, and the English, and so you can learn either way. You can learn the name of the colors. At least you get that going. Learn a little bit. We are going to start with the dark blue, and then we are going to move on to some of the other colors. Remember these templates? These are templates that we have used time and again. They're texture, and the important reason why we're using these is that we want not to have to be so careful with the paint. So we're gonna provide a little bit of texture all around the edges so that we blend out toward this, from the silver out toward the wings. I guess the wings, this looks like a great boomerang, you can throw it across the room and it will not come back to you. We're gonna do a little bit of that kind of work, and you'll see, you'll be watching here. We put the silly putty to cover a couple of areas. Now, most of this, except for the cockpit and some of these portholes here, and then, of course, the spine, those are the only things that are going to be seen through the cover. And there is our lovely cover, and that cover too will be painted, and we are going to apply some graphics to it. So this is this is quite a bit of fun that we're having. And you know, using the airbrush and the Vallejo paints, I believe makes it a lot much more fun, more challenging. And it's just, for me anyway, it's a little bit more rewarding. And it does save you a lot of time, believe it or not. Initially you think, no, I'm just gonna get my brush out and I'm gonna hand paint it. The airbrush gives you some amazing effects, as you will see very quickly in this next video. All right, so we're gonna do a little sequence here, paint sequence on getting the scythe painted. So we're gonna clear up our work area and shoot some paint. So stay tuned in for that, my friends. More Cranky Show coming your way.